In this video, we are going to analyze in details how some parts of the Eureka EnviroVac vacuum cleaner were manufactured. After disassembly in the vacuum, a list of parts was generated. From this list, three parts were chosen to be analyzed in more details because of their shape complexity, materials property, and relation to some of the manufacturing processes covered in this course. The first part we decided to analyze is the roller brush. In this model, the roller brush is made out of wood, which is not used often in these types of application. Most models have in fact plastic rollers. It seems that in this case, the manufacturing process starts with a rough wood cylinder. Since all of the external features are symmetric about the axis of rotation, we believe that the shapes are obtained through a turning process carried out on an automatic CNC wood lathe. In order to attach the mini brushes to the wood cylinders, holes are drilled following a spiral path. The mini brushes are then inserted in these holes and secured with steel staples. This part could have also been produced with plastics, like many manufacturers do, and the same shape could have been accomplished through a blow molding process.
The second part that we decided to analyze is the clip bracket, which is used to constrain the roller brush about its rotational axis. It is made of high-strength, anodized steel and was likely manufactured through a series of rolling, forming, and die-cutting operations. First, the raw stock was rolled to a thickness of a fraction of an inch and then collected on a coil for easy storage and transport. The coiled sheet metal was then transferred to a manufacturing line where it was unrolled, press-formed, and cut into the desired shape in a continuous die-cutting process. Evidence of this can be seen in the continuous cross-section of the piece and the lack of 90-degree bends. As we can see in the photo, the steel has an anodized, corrosion-resistant, non-porous coating that has been worn away due to friction with the roller brush. The clip bracket could also have been made using die casting, but the process is generally more time-consuming and is less precise than roll form.
The plastic hose adapter was likely manufactured using an injection blow molding process. This combination of techniques is evident in the injector pin marks of the threaded head and the uniform wall thickness through the bent component. A two-step process is required where the thermoplastic material is melted into a preform mold and then transferred to a blowing station. A secondary mold is then utilized to inflate the blown shape via air pressure and the blow pin is then removed. Cooling rates for the mold temperature determine how fast the product can be processed and the blow pressure must be carefully chosen to avoid rupture. Injector blow molding produces a fully finished component which avoids the extra trimming processes associated with extrusion blow molding. An alternative manufacturing process would be rotational molding since it provides less costly molds and achieves a high production cycle by operating separate heating, cooling, and exiting or loading stations.
Thanks for watching.